what? When I discovered this, I was so mind blown, and I had to give it a try, and it actually worked. So I am so excited to share it with you. Hello, beautiful friend. Welcome. I hope you're having a wonderful day. I have something so incredibly mind-blowing to show you today, so grab some tea and cozy up. I'll be sharing a wild little secret with you that will allow you to knit Fair Isle in the round or flat using only one strand of yarn per row. If you've tried Fair Isle before and given up because it's challenging to finoodle two different strands every row, then keep watching. Also be sure to check out our other videos on how to knit Fair Isle if you are completely new to it. We'll link below to those for you. First of all, what is Fair Isle? It is a form of color work used in knitting, and it's also called stranded knitting. It creates really gorgeous geometric designs in your knitted pieces. A lot of folks are afraid to try Fair Isle because it seems super advanced, but today we are changing that. And to inspire you even further to give this technique a try, I wanted to show you how absolutely beautiful it can be in a project. Have a look at this gorgeous I-Corps pattern by Candy Key. It features absolutely stunning Fair Isle designs in a beautiful blue gradient with little pops of pink. You can see all of the beautiful different designs that Candy chose to incorporate into this sweater. I love all the little geometric shapes going along the yoke, and then this gorgeous gradient stripe here. And my favorite part is the body of the sweater, where it fades from dark to light for the main color, but then the contrasting specks fade from light to dark. You can also adjust this pattern. If you prefer a longer sweater, you can make it longer. If you would like to make more of a cropped short version, you can do that too. And if you feel comfortable adding sleeves, feel free to do that as well. We use our beloved hand-dyed Dewy DK yarn, which is a DK weight, so it's gonna work up fairly quickly for you. We opted for our 5-skein gradient kit called Rocky Shore Hues, which is a beautiful blue blend, and then the pops of pink are our pink pearl colorway. You can simplify the design if you like by just using two colors, or use as many or as few as you prefer. It's totally up to you. Check the description box for the direct link to this pattern and the yarn, or you can just head directly to expressionfiberarts.com. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with our demo. In traditional Fair Isle, you work with two colors per row. You can either hold both in your left hand, both in your right hand, or, which is what I prefer, one in each. So I'm gonna hold the blue in my left hand, the pink in my right hand. And when you follow along the chart, you're gonna knit the first two stitches with the blue. Next, we have two pink squares, so we will knit those with the pink yarn. One, two. And when you switch to your next color, I like to just keep my stitches pulled on my needle so the floats in the back stay nice and loose. Then you'll switch to the blue and knit two stitches. Again, keeping those stitches nice and stretched out. Then you'll work two stitches with the pink and continue around in that pattern. Let me show that to you again. I've moved around to the back of my tiny little sweater here, and I will show you again how to continue along. Knit two stitches with your blue. Keep those stitches loose. Knit two with the pink. And I recommend always holding the same color in the same hand if you can. That's going to help to keep your tension consistent throughout your project. So the blue in your left hand, for example, the pink in your right hand, and that'll help to make a nice look to your project. Here's a quick tip I'd love to share with you. Remember to always hold the same color of yarn in the same hand so that the tension remains the same throughout your project. And don't fear the floats on the back of your project. Just make sure to keep them loose and you'll be golden. Look at the inside of this sweater and you can see just how beautiful it is, even on the inside. Now that you've seen how Fair Isle typically works, I am going to show you a secret that you can try. Here's the scoop. You don't have to knit Fair Isle with two colors at a time. You can actually knit Fair Isle using just one color per row. What? When I discovered this, I was so mind blown, and I had to give it a try, and it actually works. So I am so excited to share it with you. Let me show you the exact same thing, but using only one strand per row. You can hold it in your left hand or in your right hand, totally up to you. You'll start by knitting those first two stitches with the blue yarn. But since we don't have the pink yarn, which we would normally use to work these stitches, we're just gonna slip them onto our right needle. Pulling that blue float along the back and continuing to keep those stitches nice and stretched. Then knit the next two stitches with the blue according to the chart. And we would normally knit these with pink, so we don't want to knit those. We're just going to slip them from our left needle to our right needle, and you'd continue working that all the way around your row. Let's continue on around our little cylinder. Obviously, this is going to be you working on your sweater, but I just wanted to do a little small version today. Skip the stitches that you're not working in the blue, so slip those onto your right-hand needle, keeping everything spread apart and loose over here. Knit the next two stitches, again keeping it loose, and then whatever is supposed to be worked in the pink, go ahead and slip those onto your right needle. Now we're going to drop the blue and pick up the pink, and we're going to go ahead and do something really similar. So the stitches that we knitted previously, you're going to slip those. In this case, it's the blue ones. Then the stitches that you slipped before that did not get worked, you're going to knit those with the pink. Keeping your stitches nice and loose so that your floats are loosey-goosey on the back, not too tight so your project doesn't pucker up. We knitted these stitches on the previous row, so we're going to slip them onto the right needle. We slipped these stitches previously, so we are going to knit them. Let's go ahead and continue around. Let me show you again on the back of my little teeny tiny sweater. The stitches that you knitted, you're going to slip. The stitches that you slipped, you're going to knit. We knitted those, so we slipped them. We slipped those, so now we knit them. And we have accomplished the same thing with only holding one strand at a time that we did before, having to hold two strands. And that, my friend, is all there is to it. Fair Isle knitting is not hard, so I encourage you to try both techniques and see which you prefer. Be sure to head to expressionfiberarts.com and sign up for email updates for free knit and crochet patterns and coupons to our online yarn shop. Have a marvelous day, friend. Go out and try some Fair Isle and see what you think, and I'm gonna see you next time. Bye for now.